Good evening. Good evening. That's so much better. My name is Jeremy Davis. I am from the magnanimous class of 1995 at Pine Forge. Before we get started, we're gonna open up with a word of prayer, and then I'm gonna talk for a couple minutes. You're gonna switch me up, so we're gonna open up with a word of prayer, and then we're gonna get rolling.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Gregory Hembry Jr. I am from the iridescent class of 2016. And everyone, please stand while we open for prayer. Please bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful Sabbath day you've given to us, Lord. We thank you for everything that you've done, and we thank you for another opportunity for us to come together and give your name the glory and the honor and the praise that you so deserve. We thank you for this choir, the director, and all the other faculty and staff who were able to get them here safely. We thank you for keeping them safe on the road. Just be with us now. We ask simply that you remind us that this is not just a concert, but a worship experience, that these are not just performers, but ministers, Lord, here to give you all the glory and all the honor and all the praise. We love you and we thank you so much, Lord. We ask all these things in your name. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, good sir. Not to kind of co-sign what was just said about it being a ministry, I want to talk a little bit about this ministry that the Pine Forge Academy Choir has actually been doing. As recent of 2021, there was a musical that they put together under directorship of Mr. Roseboro with the assistance of Dean Audie Johnson and so many others that was so impactful. That musical has won multiple film festivals. It won multiple nationally and got featured internationally in the UK. Wow. Y'all didn't know that, did you? That's just one ministry about a school on a hill that not many people know about. That's one. I'm gonna give you the two recent ones. One was from the PBS choir competition in Philly. Anybody hear about that? Now, this choir festival wasn't just for high schoolers. There were adult choirs, there were high school choirs, and you know, just church choirs here and there. They won. And more recent than that, there was a TikTok jingle contest for, what, the Nationwide? Said that they on your side. I'm gonna be honest with you. It's just, I'm not being biased, but I think God was on their side because they were one of the five winners of this competition. So again, this is a school that's on a hill that not many people know about, but they're doing powerful things. So tonight, it is my privilege to introduce my alma mater to minister you all under the directorship of Mr. Jared Roseboro, Pine Forge Academy Choir.
There's a place hidden in the hills of the northern regions, a place where the air is light, and the grass is what the old timers might call rolling green, a place like you've never seen, the scene serene and filled with the musings of the divine. Can you hear it?
Do
a place where roots have rhythms and underground is a sound of freedom in the soil, saturated by songs of royalty disguised as the reprise that tells the muddy Jordan to get away because the river is deep, and Moses has to go down in a low swinging chariot to get his people to understand exactly why the Negro speaks of rivers. If you listen closely, you can hear the souls of these folks sending praises to the Most High. Hear them. Feel them. Know them. Breathe them. Can you see them? They come from all across the land. They are the living, breathing prayers of their ancestors in human form. They come with a royal lineage that is greater than the number of the stars or the sands of the sea. They are life-breathed thoughts, spoken from the lips of divinity and woven within their being. Beating from their chest is a melody from heaven that rains rays of sunshine and silver linings, a song of songs from bonds of mercy. Listen to them sing.
Leave your cares and worries all behind. You can find a place to ease your troubled mind. You'll find peace of mind.
It is not just a song. It is an experience. It is the hand clap of the Almighty. It is the foot stomp of those who have tread the path through the blood of the slaughtered. It is the finger snap of the gatekeepers that calls the children to fall in line. It is the song that breaks generational curses yet binds us at the soul. Oh, sing a new song. It won't be long. So come along and join the throne. Welcome to the space. Welcome to the place, welcome to the sound, welcome all around, welcome one and all, welcome great and small, welcome to the experience.
Oh,
Good evening, everyone. It is such a pleasure to be able to see you all's faces on this evening. It's been a few years since we've had the opportunity to worship with you in this context. I believe the last time we were here was right at the beginning of the 2018-2019 school year. And then we made plans to worship with you all, and then COVID happened. And COVID kind of ransacked us for about 2.5 years. And so just to be able to worship with you all in this context is such a blessing to us. And we're grateful to be here with you all. I want to do a few things real quick. I'll probably be doing this throughout the entire concert. But I just want to acknowledge a friend, a colleague who's been such a wonderful support to what we do over here. And I am in love with what she is doing over with her young people over at Tacoma Academy. The director, Mrs. Lulu McFumbu, who is with us. Which, if you have not already, they just put out a wonderful album entitled Calling, and this is her and the Camerata Chorale, yes, who put out a wonderful album. Make sure you go and download it. Also, I want to say this just to make sure that I cover this. Tacoma Academy is going to be going to the World Choir Games, yes? Mm-hmm. All right. And trust me, I know, I see your white sweaters on. I see, you know, people here from years back in Pine Forest. I see it, I understand, I get it. But let me say this, and let me say this clearly. There are times when our children need our support. You all hear what I'm saying here, right? And so for me, if you'd like to meet me, above, you know, I graduated from GAAA. I'm working at Pine Forge Academy. You know, above all of that, our children need our support. So I want to say they are going to need our support. It is no small task moving groups like this, especially out of the country. It is no small task. So they're going to need our support, and we are going to support them. Good. All right. I know you all did not come to hear me talk and preach at you. So we'll get back to the voices that you are here to experience. This next piece that we want to do for you, actually these next two pieces, so that I don't have to talk in between. This one taken from the Gospel of Matthew, where Jesus is preaching to a group of exhausted individuals, and he says, "Come to me, all ye who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest." Do me a favor, though, this song, don't fall asleep on it, because it's so soothing. You know, even sometimes in rehearsal, it's like, y'all still with me and all that great stuff. So, another piece that we're going to do to contrast that one, Hermani Aguiar is a Brazilian composer, takes and combines this idea of Gregorian chant and this little Brazilian flair, and takes on the language of Latin to arrange, compose this piece, Psalm 150, which the excitement of that piece, as we all know it, that's the scripture that says, praise him with a timbrel and dance, praise him upon the high-sounding cymbal, let everything that hath breath praise ye the Lord. So we'll hear those in this order. This is Come to Me and Psalm 150. Thank you. So one of my favorite Adventist composers, a man by the name of Cedric Dent, you all are familiar with that gentleman, Take Six Emeritus, Grammy Award winning, and all of the above. Before he had Take Six, he had this quartet out in Detroit. I do not remember the name of it, but those of you who are familiar with Pine Forge, Chris Fielder, used to sing in this quartet with Cedric Dent. Ask him about it. He used to sing this quartet with Cedric Dent. And so every time we get to this song, I like to just pick on him just a little bit because he's such an underrated musician, Chris Fielder is. And so I am going to call forward my senior gentleman. If you would make your way down to the front, you all just kind of. So this is Cedric Dent's quartet arrangement, Come By Here.
Come by, my Lord.
blow up their heads too much. Don't do that. This next piece that we want to do, I always have to preface it when you first hear it. It's a war piece. What kind of piece did I say it was?
War.
Okay. Russian composer puts together this piece taken from the psalm, David being a man of war. He transcribes this psalm that says, "Some trust in chariots, some trust in horses, but we will trust in the name of our God." And so, if this song feels all over the place, if it feels a little bit frantic and all that great stuff, it's supposed to be exactly that way. And so I hope that you will enjoy This Is Chariots. And so this is going to feature our honor choir. I'm going to pull our full choir members, if you would, either this row here, find a spot for me, and then honor choir, go ahead and move into place for me. This next piece that we'll do for you, an arranger by the name of Dr. Mark Butler. Those of you who are familiar with the Aeolian repertoire just throughout the years, there was a song that really kind of honestly, I feel like they put on the map as far as Dr. Butler is concerned, called Signs of the Judgment. It's even in their repertoire even now. So I'll make this long story short, just a testimony. Dr. Mark Butler wanted to create a premiere for this particular piece that we're going to do next. The publishing company heard some recording of Pine Forge. I'm not even necessarily sure up to this day, but reached out and asked if Pine Forge would be willing to be the premier choir for this piece for Dr. Mark Butler. So anywhere if you go and look up Mark Butler's arrangement of Jacob's Ladder, and you are looking or listening to a recording, that recording is Pine Forge Academy. And so we want to render for you, This Is Jacob's Ladder. Thank you. I'm going to invite up, and those of you who've seen this before, I want to say it just about changes every time, but nonetheless, I am just grateful for the gift that are these students and their flexibility. I'm going to invite up a soprano trio. It's going to consist of a sophomore, Janai Wilson. Senior Zara Vanderhorst. And Junior Maylin Chavers. This next section of the concert, and we are soon coming to a close of this first half. I'm going to title it, in the goodness of God, I'm going to title this The Winning Circle, right? And I'll explain to you why it's going to be called the Winning Circle. This first piece that you are going to hear, for those of you who had the opportunity to witness the musical that was talked about earlier, This Is My Black, God has just blessed us in so many areas. We were able to enter into over 20 film festivals. We won 11 film festival awards, and what was not mentioned before, two of those festivals were international festivals. So if you go and look up the Out of Africa International Film Festival, and one that was also over in England, it slips my mind now, you will also see Pine Forge Academy's name as one of the winning individuals for that. All right, enough talking about that. This piece that you're going to hear is going to feature our very own poet laureate, if you will, a senior by the name of Azriel Prevett. And I will let her come in her own way.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening. Hi, so this poem is titled Happy in My Own Skin, or otherwise known as I Love My Black, and I pray that you all are blessed. I love my black. I love my hair. It moves slow, but it grows. I love my skin when in the sun it glows. I love my dark beauty found deep within. I am happy in my own colored skin. I love my hair, the endless teasing and scarves I bear, the wandering eyes that love to stare, the naps and the kinks, the lengthy strands that love to shrink, the numerous styles I've had to rethink. I love my hair. I love my skin. The sun makes it pop from all the dark melanin, and because there's a sense of pride found deep within, I am in love, absolutely in love with the color of my beautiful skin. I love my look, my hazel eyes that leave everyone else in the room shook, the extra fat under my arms that helps me cook, the thick curls that hold in place every crochet hook. I love my look. I love our people. I love our modern churches without steeples, our unique names like Malik, Diamond, and Cecil. I love our history that comes crashing in like a flood, our race that has been raked through the mud, the strength that is found deep within my blood. I love our people. I love our food. It always brings a happy and a carefree mood. Huh. You better stay out of mama's way or else you'll be screwed. Mac and cheese, collards, sweet potato pie, and don't y'all let me forget fried chicken. Mm. Steps to the kitchen, they often quicken, and the bellies of its consumers, it never fails to thicken. I love our food. I love our music. It's almost as if our stuff is therapeutic. Jazz, R&B, rap, and gospel, they course through our veins. They're genres that are wide and don't really constrain because they break up those emotions and pains that have resulted in heavy chains. I love our music. I love our dance. I love our colorful shoes and our fancy pants. The words that go with each new stance, the twists and jumps that put you in a trance. Popping, locking, and break are just a few. And because this phenomenon isn't particularly new, it's been tried through and through. I love our dance. Have you grown into your own skin? No matter your color, can you see that you're beautiful deep within? If not, try looking from God's point of view. He took 7 days to create a perfect world for me and you. You know what? Scratch that. It's time that you grow into your own skin. You can't expect to become better than you are now if it's your previous self you can't win. Stop the doubt and let a little faith in. I need you to stop being upset and accept the fact that you and I are not the world's idea of perfect. Take a step back from yourself, a look in the mirror, and a moment to reflect. God made us black, and we're in a sinful world. What did you expect? But because God made us black, that means our color is not a defect. You are black, and that's something you should learn to respect. I said it once, and I'll say it again. Sweetheart, our color is not a defect.
Thank you. Okay, so I'm not going to tell you what this next song is. I'm going to let you listen to it. I'm going to let you tell you that it won a competition. Yeah, it won a competition. And you'll figure it out once you hear it. Anybody want to take a guess at what that competition was for? Yeah? Okay. Yeah, State Farm. Go ask Jake. Yeah. A little bit before that, like I said, God bless. And I really want to just, and we've spoke about this as we were in this competition, that these, what we're talking about is not a statement of arrogance, but one of divine favor, right? We're not making any claims that, you know, somehow our pride and whatever got us where God has us, but it is that we are very legitimately, and if you ask me, there are so many stories of the witness that these children have been in arenas outside of the walls of our church. And More than anything, that's really what it's all about. So we want to go to this next particular piece, and then we'll do one more and go to our intermission for the evening. This piece we did in the WHYY. It's a broadcasting network that is PBS and NPR affiliated. They put out an all call for groups, and like I said, God just blessed. The journey was one that was nothing short of amazing, because the time frame in which they pulled all together what we did was challenging, to say the least. And so you're just looking at some amazing, anointed, hardworking kids behind me. This next arrangement is the piece that won the WHYY competition. This is Sooner Will Be Done with the Troubles of the World.
Soon, 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 soon. Soon I will be done now with the troubles of this world, with the troubles of this world, with the troubles of this world. Soon I will be done now with the troubles of this world, going home to live with God. Oh God. I want to meet my mother. I want to meet my father. I want to meet my father, going home to live with God. Soon I will be done now with the troubles of this world, with the troubles of this world, with the troubles of this world. Soon I will be done now with the troubles of this world, going home to live with God.
Thank you.
So we'll end our first half here. A song that is very familiar to any choral enthusiast whatsoever, but no matter how many times we sing this piece, we always feel some fresh revelation about it just because of what it means to us in our lives. Taken from the scripture in Psalm 8, David says, "What is man that thou art mindful of him? For you've made him a little lower than the angels." And it is just that majesty and glory of God's name that we want to just praise on this evening. So we will close out this first half of our concert, Majesty and Glory of Your Name.
Thank you.
Y'all didn't believe me, did you? Y'all didn't believe me, did you? I'm telling you, it's a small school on a hill that the Lord is moving to do big things. Okay. So, I have to be honest with you. I can't count how many times I've heard this choir since my children started attending this school. And every time I hear this choir, it touches me differently. I know what they're gonna sing before they sing it. But once they've sung it, I feel different. And it touches me every single time. So I say all that to say, you all should have the same opportunity that I have to see your children minister the way my children minister. You all have the same, for those of you all who have children who are getting ready to go to high school or would like to go to high school one day, but not at home. You should have the same opportunity that I have to feel what I feel every time I see my children sing. Amen. I'm gonna leave it at that. But with that being said, they didn't get here on air. They took two buses on diesel. And you know, diesel is not, ain't nowhere near cheap. Two buses. With that being said, after I finish talking and we have prayer, there's going to be a promo. But there's going to be some deacons walking around, myself included. We're going to need you to allow the Lord to move you to put something in that bucket. Because again, they did not come here on air. And we got to get them home. And the people that drove them here need to be compensated the same. The staff that are here should be compensated the same. So with that being said, I'm going to pass the mic to our VP, Miss Rhodes, so she can have a couple words that are not my own.
I have to say Mr. Davis, since we're old now. Mr. Davis and I went to Pine Forge together. He enjoys telling people that I am the elder, and it's true. I'll take that. Today's my birthday. I'll allow for that. But God is good. So as the deacons are deaconing, I'm going to pray for the offering, and then I'm going to bring up a wonderful young lady who is also a Pine Forge alum and has a heart for Pine Forge like I do. So if you'll bow your heads with me, let's pray together. Father, we are excited about the work that you're doing, not just at your school, but in your children. And we understand that today's world is a different space. And so we ask that you bless us so that we can bless them. Bless our pockets so that we can bless your school and your children. Bless this offering, God, in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, I'm going to ask Courtney Thornton to come up. Did I say all of it? I didn't. I'm sorry. Yes, here comes Mr. Davis again.
Hello. So if you are digital and would like to contribute, you could send it to our realm. Of course, AV, can we get those options on the screen? I'm sorry, I didn't cue you all with that earlier. But we do have digital options. It's Cash App. I'm not going to read them. You can see them. So please, if you don't have it loose in your pocket, pull out your phones and go ahead and put in a couple numbers. We appreciate it. And when you do it online, if you do on Realm, send it to combined budget. Thank you.
All right. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's so good to see you all. I tell you, listening to this choir, it brought back memories when I was in the choir traveling to different churches. It looks a little different with the addition of movement. We were not allowed to move when I was in the choir. But now they move a little more, and I am thoroughly enjoying this, looking forward to the second half. I am here on behalf of the National Pine Forge Alumni Association. I think we have some alum in the room. We are under the leadership of Sikoni Scott, and I am your executive vice president currently. Amen. Amen. Are there any alum in the building? Okay, I need you all to pretend like you went to Pine Forge Academy. Are there alum in this building? Okay, okay, okay. All right, that's more like it. We're going to do a quick participatory event. We have some Pine Forge gear here, but I need some help. So I have three categories. Our first being, who is the oldest alum in this room? We're not going to go by age. We'll go by class to spare some things. So do we have any pioneers in the room today? We have a pioneer in the building? My goodness gracious. Please stand up and say your name. Class of 1959. Well, for you, we have a duffel bag with a hoodie and some goodies, and we thank you so much for coming. We thank you. This is our oldest member in the building. Next, our second one is we have the legacies, legacy families. So are there any families that are two generations here today? Yes. Oh, we have a two generations. All two generation families, please stand at this time. Okay, okay. Beautiful, beautiful. beautiful, beautiful. Okay, I think I know who may win this one. Do we have three generations in the building? Oh, we have multiple three generations. Okay, multiple three generations. So may you please say your three generations? Names and years. Amen. And did I see another three generation? Please say the name. That was three. Yeah. And so we have two grandparents, a parent, and a student currently, and then one here. Mercy. God is so good. I'm not going to take up any more of your time, but you will receive your gifts at the end of the concert. Thank you so much.
We are excited about alumni. I'm excited about alumni. I am the first generation from my family. And then my brother followed me, and my cousin was in there. I have a couple of cousins in there. And now my youngest son will be graduating from the academy in May. The one I gave birth to, there are so many that you come in contact with. Here's a short blurb. So my oldest son right now is a PhD student at Howard University. And he came today to surprise his mother on her birthday. And he slipped up beside me and he said, "Mom," and I didn't move because I have so many other students that call me Mom. So I just thought it was one of the other ones. And I turned around and looked. I said, "Oh, it's the one I gave birth to." He said, "You don't know?" I said, "There are too many." Anyhow, it's a blessing, all these young people. So we're grateful for our alumni that are in the house. If you sent a child to Pine Forge, if you're sponsoring a child right now at Pine Forge, if you're like me eating beans and rice because that baby is at the school, can you wave your hand in the air? Because that's all the energy you have right now. We're grateful for you. We have quite a few people who have given not just their children to us, but they have given their time. I have a wonderful lady who comes up every so often and says, "What can I do to help?" She just pops up on campus. She's an alum, she and her sister. We have people who give us money. We have people who call and just say, "We're praying for you." And I want to recognize those people. So if you're a part of that group, if you just prayed for us this morning, you're a part of that group. Can you give yourself a hand? Give yourself a hand. We're grateful for what you do. I'm going to sit in just a minute, but I want to give you some updates. I know that you have heard that we've been in renovation for the last year and a piece. Well, I can praise the Lord because on Thursday, we got the occupancy certificate, and our young people are moving out of the cabins and into the dorms. God is good. You're not as excited as we are. Listen, cabin living, we're grateful. Let me fix it because my bosses are here. So cabin living is good. We're grateful that we had a cabin to go to. We are thankful for the hot water in the cabin. But we're so excited about these dorms. They are phenomenal. I see my young people here, but I do want you to see this video, so they're gonna hold for me for just a second. So if you get a chance to come up in February, if you're a Pine Forge alum, you know that we have Kimbrough Hall weekend and Handy Hall weekend. We separate them. The gentlemen take care of one weekend, the ladies take care of another one. Well, because we are so excited about this renovation and its completion, we're doing the two weekends together so that you could come up and see the open house that's happening in the dorms. We want you to experience the screams of joy that the young people experienced when they moved into those dorms on Thursday. I heard screaming at my house. And then I'm getting text. So we're really excited. We want you to be able to come. So keep the first weekend in February open so that you can come up and do the open house. I will say no more. I'm going to ask our AV team if they will put on my video. You're going to see what the inside of some of these dorms look like, and we're grateful for it. Thank you.
Let us pray. God, we find ourselves here grateful for your goodness, your mercy, and your grace. Lord, we thank you for the reason that we stand here in this beautiful building that has been refurbished, Lord, for the development of the young men that you bring here. God, we thank you for the dean to keep them, give them wisdom, guidance, and protection as they guide and keep the precious vessels that the families have brought to this institution. But we also ask that you keep Kimbrough as it's working its way to its final stages also. Bless the men and women who are living these halls, Lord. May these halls bless them spiritually. For eternity we pray, and may your spirit be sound in these halls. And this is our prayer in Jesus' name. And all will agree, say
amen.
My name is Jalen Johnson from the Perspicacious Class of 2024, and I want to thank every single person who donated for the renovation of our dorms. These dorms mean a lot to me because my freshman year during quarantine, we spent a majority of our days in the dorms, and I am so grateful that the next generation of Pine Forge Academy students will be able to live in a more updated dorm than I did. Thank you so much for all that you have done for us. I really, really appreciate it.
As they prepare to come back forward, that was a piece entitled Sifuni Mungu, written in the Swahili dialect. And the basic idea behind that piece celebrates the soon coming king, and celebrates the idea that one day the king or the ruler or the god is going to return, and how great a god we serve. That piece, Sifuni Mungu. Okay, so with this next piece, I have to do just a small faith check every time that we sing this piece. The word of God says that weeping endures for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Do we believe that? Now, I don't mean to sound blasphemous. Like, do we actually believe that, or do we need to hear the scripture for us to believe it? Like, do we actually believe that? Okay, the word of God says that we should not worry for things like what we're going to eat, what we're going to drink, because our Heavenly Father knows those things. Now, do we actually believe that? Or is it like we need somebody to actually quote the scripture to us to let us know that that's a biblical idea? Do we believe that? All right, so these young people are gonna sing a few songs. They're gonna be familiar, but they're not gonna be familiar for the reason that you think they're gonna be familiar. But I just want you to hear the message and know our hearts in reaching the world. This is what we call our little medley of hope.
Don't you worry, no. rise up this morning, up with the rising sun. Three little birds was by my doorstep, singing sweet songs with melodies pure and true. This is my message to you. Don't worry about this pain, 'cause every little thing is gonna be alright. Rise up this morning, up with the rising sun. Three little birds perch by my doorstep, singing sweet songs with melodies pure and true. This is my message to you. Don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be alright. Don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be alright.
Mr. Davis, if you could put us an F. So, I have to do this, and she'll kill me for it later, but it was on my mind, and what better perfect time to do this? She's already embarrassed, you know, throughout the day. But today is our vice principal's birthday. singer happy birthday. worship with us to come out. Help us like that is to sing. Goes like this, and Father of
more. Thank you.
hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, the Lord which made heaven and earth. He said he would not suffer my foot to be moved. The Lord that keepeth me, he will not slumber nor sleep. For the Lord is my keeper, the Lord is my strength. Upon thy right hand, upon thy right hand, and the sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. He shall preserve my soul, even for. I've come too far, and I'm never turning.
Cardi.
Do y'all mind if I teach you all a song real quick? I know the hour is late. It's a simple song, but it's on my spirit to leave with you all this evening. Right? It's a simple song. I'm gonna walk. So the spirit kind of just gave me this song as I was working on a project, if you will. And The words are so simple, but it has such a poignant meaning. The words simply say, life may get you down, troubles all around. I'm not alarmed, for in your arms I am safe, I am healed, I am loved. Like I said, it's simple, right? First part goes like this. Life may get you down. Can y'all try that for me? Next part says, trouble all around. This next part says, I'm not alone, for in your arms I'm. This is my favorite part. It says, I am safe, I am here, I am loved. If you don't remember anything else, just that right there, sing it for me. I am safe. One more time, just so that you believe it. Life may get you. Trouble all around. I'm not alone. Thank you. remember your part. It goes like this. Sing.
I am saved. I am here. I am loved.
Come on, just let that minister to your spirit.
I am saved.
To the top, life make it. We're done for the evening. We're going to end. We'll end here. You know, there's just some stuff. It's undeniable that the Holy Spirit is in. That in a world of chaos, to know that in the arms of God, no matter what happens, oof. That when I am in God's arms, I am safe. I'm here. And rest assured, the word of God says there is nothing that can separate you from the love that is in Christ Jesus.
I am saved. There's a sweet, sweet spirit in this. And I know that it's the spirit. Expressions, there are sweet expressions on each face. Come on, just one time. Sweet Holy Spirit. Sweet Heavenly. Stay. I don't need to talk. The Holy Spirit is in this place. I simply ask this, those of our family who are in the audience, reverently, please, would you just join us for this moment? Come on up. Come on. Guys.
So you all just got a concert. This is what's walking around that campus day after day, week after week, month after month, being ingrained in these children, that one day they will get home someday. There's really nothing else I need to say other than, like I said before, if you have a child who is of, even if they're already in high school, if they're in public school, they can go to Pine Forge. People like to say Pine Forge alum are prideful. Can I be honest with you all? We're not prideful. We just know what we've been through, what we got, and what we're taking with us. If you want your child to have that same type of experience, and I'll be honest with you, that sticker price will shock you. But I will tell you this, if God means for your child to be there, that sticker price means a hill of beans. I'm a willing testament. I have two there. Will my babies please raise their hands? Unfortunately, their daddy did not give them height, so if you just saw a hand, that's my fault. I apologize, but all jokes aside, were you not blessed? Were you not ministered to? It will be a crying shame for you to feel this ministry, to feel this Holy Spirit, and deprive your child of the same opportunity. It would be a crying shame. Right now, the numbers of Pine Forge is under 120. At minimum, we should be at least 200. At minimum. And I'll repeat again, it would be a crying shame for you all to experience this, those who are online as well, and deprive your children of this. So with that being said, when you leave, if you know of someone who could benefit from being here, even if they ain't your child, your nephew, niece, your next door neighbor, we'll take them all. Because there's something here that they need to take with them when they're on their own. And that's no shot at any other school. Earlier, Mr. Roseboro said we need to support TA, and we should. Because that's their ministry on the other side of the world. It is our job to help them get there. But on the flip side, there's children you know that need to be here. The Lord will make a way. He will make a way. I mean, I know my mom's watching, so I'm not going to say nothing. But back then, the three-way scholarship was a godsend. And she put me through by herself. So I'm going to leave that alone. I'm going to leave it alone. But before I go any further, I do have to thank a group of people who actually made all this possible. Starting off with our senior pastor, Dr. Peeler. It started with a text, and that thing snowballed so fast that this is what you got from a text. On his way out of town to minister to his family, a text. Next thing you know, I'm talking to Miss Janice, Allen. I don't know if she's still here. there's some food for y'all on the bus. Started from a text. And thank you. I wanted you all to come all school year. And now that you're here, it's gonna be easier for you to come back. But with that being said, was it not great to be here tonight? So you got something to look forward for next year, right? I'm gonna throw a little curveball in there. Next year, I'm bringing the creative arts team too. Because I want you all to know, it's not just singing that we do. We minister through drama as well. And under the leadership of Señorita Martin, you'll have a full day of blessings. So as we prepare to depart, I'm going to ask our senior pastor to come up and close us out. And as you go, just keep in mind, you know of at least one person's child who could benefit from being with these children. Thank you for coming.
Can we give God the glory for Pine Forge Academy Choir? We can do better than that. Y'all. Yeah. Young people on fire for the Lord, lifting up their voices, giving God the praise. Awesome. Awesome. For their director, come on, let's give God the glory for. Brother Jerry. For the spirit that is present, we thank God for him. And I want you to know we appreciate you, Jeremy. Our Pine Forge Academy representative for Capitol Hill. We thank you. We know you love, you believe Pine Forge Academy. And I thank God for your advocacy for that great institution. Once again, we thank God for you and all who have been a part of this night. I felt that there's been some transition into the repertoire. I heard a little reggae. I heard a little R&B. I heard a little Stevie. I heard a little Bill Withers. But I heard a lot of God. And I love the movement because we need our young people to be free. Because whom the Son sets free, he frees indeed. They did a little this, little that, and it's all good. Let's all stand for prayer. Thank God for what we've seen and felt and heard on tonight. Father, in the name that is above every name, we thank you, Lord, for the grand occasion of this concert and ministry. We know that some life online or in the house has been touched. And so, Lord, would you just let them know that they are loved and that they are healed and that your big arms have surrounded them and given them one more chance. So, God, we're just asking that you would take them and surround them and give them the blessing of salvation. And so, Lord, as these young people get on the bus and they begin to journey their way back up to the hill, would you just give them peace that passes all understanding? Give them an awareness of the times and give them power to do their ministry. So I thank you and I praise you for what we've felt, seen, and heard. And Lord, just cover them and their families as they prepare for the coming of you real soon. So I praise you and I thank you. And grant us entrance into that kingdom when you come again. In the mighty and matchless name of Jesus, if you've been blessed tonight, once again, put your hands together and adoration to the King of Kings. One more time, Pine Forge Academy Choir.
Thank you.